Fe gamma and Fe alpha. Gamma form of iron has FCC. This has got FCC structure. Beta form beta form has BCC structure. Not alpha, beta. Form FCC structure. Edge length are given. In case of gamma iron, A is equal to, for the unit cell, is equal to 386 pm. And here it is, A is equal to 290 pm. What is asked? What is the ratio? Ratio of density in gamma form and beta form. That means density of gamma form to beta form. Ratio of density of gamma form to beta form is asked. Now, how can we calculate this? Appears to be a very difficult problem, no? Using the formula, D is equal to Z into M divided by AQ into NA, we can easily write. How can we say that this is D1 and D2, or this is D gamma, this is D beta. D1 can be written, it is Z1, because D1 is FCC. D2 means beta form, it is not FCC, sorry. This is BCC. Z means effective number of particles are different. Therefore, I will write D1 as Z1 into M is same because it is iron and iron. M is nothing but atomic masses. It cannot change, it is same. Edge length is different, it is given. This is A1 and this is actually A2 given. So, this is, I will write A1 cube into, this is NA, where NA is Avogadro number. That is also constant. So, D1 is equal to Z1 into M into A1 cube NA. D2 is equal to Z2 into M divided by A2 cube into NA. If you make D1 by D2, if you take D1 by D2, it will be equal to Z1 M into A1 cube divide this divided by this. What gets cancelled? MM gets cancelled. NA, NA gets cancelled. Avogadro number gets cancelled. What is left out? It is Z1 by Z2. And this is A1 cube in the denominator, A2 cube in the numerator. Therefore, it is A2 divided by A1 whole to the power of 3. So, this is the simple formula. Remember this. This is density of a unit cell. This is comparison of density of two unit cells. One may be FCC, the other one may be BCC. One may be simple cube, the other one may be BCC. So, whenever two forms are given, how do you compare? What will be the ratio? D1 by D2 is equal to Z1 by Z2 divided by A1 by A2. This is A2 divided by A1 whole to the power of 3. This simplified version should be remembered first. You don't keep on deriving this in the examination. You don't have that much of time. So, once if it is remembered by you, the D gamma divided by D beta, it is as good as D1 by D2 is equal to Z, what is that? Z gamma. It is equal to Z gamma divided by Z beta into, what is that? A2 means A beta divided by A gamma whole to the power of 3. So, you will have to simplify this by substitution. It appears to be that how to simplify A to the power of 3 and all. Will it be possible within a minute? Of course, you will have to be quicker. You can be more smarter than us. Or you will have to be smarter than this because you are facing the examination, not me. So, you will have to solve as many problems as possible such that all things are remembered or by-hearted by you. So, that is why we have been asking you to solve as many as problem as possible so as to remember all these simplifications. Now, this is given. D gamma to be calculated. D gamma divided by D beta is equal to Z gamma, number of particle per unit cell in FCC, that is 4. Number of particle per unit cell in BCC, it is equal to 2 into, and fractions are here. Appearing to be, when you substitute, you will definitely find it irritating when I substitute the values. Because it is, say 290 divided by 286 290 divided by 386 whole to the power of 3. You will have to simplify this. 4 by 2, of course, anybody can simplify, say, and say, sir, it is 2. What about 290 divided by 386 whole to the power of 3? It will be 2 into. What is the idea? Go for approximation. What I will do? 290, I will take it 300. I will round it off. Okay, I have made an approximation. We are arriving at an approximate answer. No worry. I will make it 400. For having increased the denominator, numerator, by some number, I will increase the denominator also by a small number. Thereby, the difference is very small. The ratio is good. Difference in the ratio is very small. This is whole to the power of 3. Now, it comes to, it is 2 into, this is 3 by 4. Okay. 3 by 4 whole to the power of 3. 3 by 4 whole to the power of, this is, it gets cancelled. 3 by 4, 3 into 3 into 3, it is 27. And divided by 4, how much it will be? 4 into 4 into 4, means 64. So, it is 27 into 2, that is 54 by 64. What can be the answer? 54 by 64, again you can make it an approximation, 50 by 60. Or it will be less than 1. One can say that 54 divided by 64 is less than 1. Now, let us see the alternative answers, they given here. Answer is, first option is 0.9788. Is it not less than 1? Is it not closer to 1 also? Not only this 54 by 64 is less than 1 and it is closer to 1 also, the answer should be somewhere around 0.9. Anybody can guess that. For that, no calculator is required. And other answers are 1.02, although it is slightly different. Anyway, whatever be the correct answer, it cannot be more than 1, you know. So, no answer here given. In case any answer that is given more than 1, definitely it is wrong. So, second option and third option, which are more than 1 here, are not correct. Fourth option is given 0.6. Definitely this ratio cannot be as low as 0.6. And therefore, the first option, which is the correct answer, should be 0.9788. It means, if you go for the correct calculation for all these, I have made so much of approximation. In spite of that, we have arrived at the answer is around 0.9, and thereby we can say that the first option is the correct option. So this is all the ideas that are required if you want to answer the questions within a minute or two. So that is why we have been telling you will have to be very, very smart enough. Okay, then question number 21. This problem, again, based on voids. Again, interesting. Interesting to people like us only, probably. But if you take all the problems, solving the problem, if you have that attitude of enjoying the solving the problems, then definitely it will be interesting. In a closed pack structure of mixed oxides, FCC lattice is composed of oxide ions. While reading, you get that. Many things are given. Don't worry, get worried by that. What is that? It is a close packing. Close packing of what? Oxide. Which oxide? Metal oxides. What are the metal oxides? One is A, the other one is B, and one is oxygen, that is O. What should be the formula? Formula should be in terms of A, B, and O. And how do you write the formula? It is based on number of A present in the unit cell, number of B that is present in the unit cell, and O that is present in the unit cell. That gives you the formula. Very simple. So, how much of O is there? It is given that in the mixed oxide, oxide ion forms FCC. Once it is that, something forms FCC, that is how many numbers? 4 in numbers. Oxide ion form FCC, therefore in the unit cell, oxygen 4 is in number. Okay. Carbon forms FCC. How many form carbon atoms? Chloride forms FCC. How many chloride atoms in the unit cell? 4. Once it is given that the crystal lattice is FCC, of what? Of X atoms, then 4 X atoms are there in the unit cell. This is the conclusion. So, remember that. I have told several times to you. Now, how? How to find out A and B? This is, once it is 4, number of particles that forms the close packing is 4. Tetrahedron voids, how many? Double this, 8. How many octahedron voids? It is 4. This can be arrived at or can be remembered immediately. because you have been told whenever n number of particles are there in close packing, 2n number of tetrahedral voids and n number of octahedral voids. That is why I have written 4 is the number of particles in close packing, 8 is the tetrahedral voids, 4 is the octahedral voids. Now, what next is? 1/8 of the tetrahedral void occupied by A. 1/8 of tetrahedral void means totally there are 8 tetrahedral voids. 1/8 of it is occupied, and how much is occupied? Only 1 is occupied. There are 8 tetrahedral voids, all are not occupied. Only 1 is occupied. Therefore, how many A are there? Only 1 A is there in the unit cell of ABO4. Okay. How many octahedral voids are there? Octahedral voids are 4. How much are occupied actually? Half of the octahedral voids are occupied is given in the problem. Half of the octahedral voids are occupied means 2 octahedral voids are occupied, and therefore B is 2. Hence the formula is A1B2O4. So by calculating number of particles present in the unit cell based on the number of voids that are filled, one can write the formula. So this is an example. Such for come, I mean, questions are every likely, and try to solve many more problems of the same kind. Thereby, you will be well versed with that type of problems. Now, one more interesting problem is there. What we do here, you know, here in this problem, what we have given? We have given how many particles are there in how many voids. And the formula is asked. There are some other type of problems. We are always there to make the problems difficult and difficult. Why? Because we are not going to select you, we are going to eliminate you. Okay. The objective of all these competitive examination is to eliminate as many students as possible, leaving, I mean, getting only the cream layer. So whenever the question is, the objective is to eliminate, then the questions will always be difficult. So be prepared for always difficult questions. Simple questions are always there. That can be answered by memory. How many particles per unit cell in BCC that any, I mean, one who scores 30 or 35% in the annual examination will answer that question. Okay. So you will have to be in a position to answer the type of the question which I am going to take now. Very interesting problem and requires correct imagination of all this crystal type. A crystal is made up of particles X, Y and Z. X forms FCC packing. What you can understand? X forms FCC packing. How many X are there in the unit cell? So what should be the formula? It is in terms of X, Y and Z only. These are the particles that are present. And X forms FCC and its number should be 4. Immediately we can write that. Now the question, how many Ys are there and Zs are there? Y occupies all the octahedral voids. How many octahedral voids? Already told, 4 octahedral voids. Why 4? And Z occupies all the tetrahedral voids. How many tetrahedral voids? 8. So what's the formula of the compound? It is X4, Y4, Z4, fine. When no particles are removed from the unit cell. Now what is asked? Okay, fine. If this is the formula of the unit cell when no particles are removed, calculate or find out what would be the formula if all the particles along the body diagonal are removed. See how much these people are thinking, who formulate or who frame the question. Now you will have to think, what are the particles that are present in the body diagonal? Then only we can say. Unless we know that, it is not possible to answer. Okay, the units. Body diagonal. What is this? It is FCC. FCC means corner particle is surrounded by, corner is surrounded by X. I mean, corner is occupied by X. Here also corner particle occupied by X. So along the body diagonal, all the particles are removed means, how many particles are there along this body diagonal? There are 2X, those 2X are removed. And how many Y are removed? Where are Y? Y are present in the octahedral void. Which is the octahedral void? The center of the body diagonal is octahedral void, and there is in the octahedral void, there is, what is that Y? How many Y are there along the body diagonal? Only 1 Y is there. And along the body diagonal, there are 2 tetrahedral voids already told. Where is the, what is the location of the tetrahedral void? I told in the beginning itself, or some in my explanation it has come, there are two tetrahedron voids along the body diagonal. So here this is body diagonal, sorry, tetrahedral void. This is also tetrahedral void. This is occupied by Z. This is occupied by Z. So what are the particles removed? All the particles along the body diagonal are removed. Means 2x are removed, 2z are removed, and 1y is removed. Therefore, what would be the formula? You may come to say that immediately x, two particles are removed. Therefore, earlier 4 were there. Now 2 particles are removed. Therefore, it is x2. And y, 1 is removed, therefore y3, z, there are 2 that are removed, it is z6. This is what you have written right, because these particles are not shared by other unit cells. All are inside only. This is also inside only. And if you remove, the entire contribution is removed. But if this is removed, you are not removing all the particle. You have already shown, I have, in a unit cell, this much is not there. It is only 1/8 of the corner particle that is present in the unit cell. And here also this much is not there. How much you have removed? Not one particle that is present in the corner. 1/8 in that corner and 1/8 in this corner. That means only you have removed 2/8 you have removed. That means 1/4 you have removed. How much of left? Z is equal to 4 minus 1 by 4 is left. So don't write immediately come to a conclusion that hasty conclusion is always wrong. So don't come to that conclusion that it is not x2, it is you have removed, because one corner particle is shared by 8 such unit cell. The contribution to the given unit cell is only 1/8. One particle, although we say we removed, actually we removed from the unit cell only 1/8 of it. So we have removed 2/8, 1/4. I should write the formula. It is 3/4 that is left out. That is 4 minus 1 by 3. 4 minus 1 by 3. It is equal to 3/4, or also I can write it is 15 by 3. Okay. When 3/4. Okay. It is 3, 12. You can 3/4, 4 into 3, 12 plus 2, 15. 15 by 4. 4 minus 1 by 4, not 3. 4 minus 1 by 4. 4 by 4 means 16 by 4. And this is minus 1 by 4. Denominator is same. It comes to 15 by 4. This is also 15 by 4. 3/4 means. So I will write 3/4, or I can write x is equal to, it is 15 by 4 and y is equal to 3, z equal to 6. I can write x is equal to multiply by 5, x 15, y how much it is, y 12, and z is equal to 24. Removing this 4, fraction I am going to remove, I made it 15. Again, you can make a simpler ratio. It is 15 is to 12 is to 24. You can make a simpler ratio means by dividing by 3. If this can be divided by 3, this also can be divided by 3. All that can be divided by 3. Therefore, it is x 5 and y 4 and z 8. But y and z remains the same. Only x is changed by how much at the other. Instead of x 4, it comes to x 5. It is not decreased, rather it is increased, the ratio. So x 5, y 4, z 8 is going to be the formula. So this is what the idea is required. In a hypothetical solid, C atoms are found to form cubical closed packed lattice, means FCC lattice. A atoms occupy all the tetrahedral voids, B atoms occupy all the octahedral voids. A and B atoms are of appropriate size so that there is no distortion in the CCP lattice of C atoms. Now, if a plane as shown in the following figure is cut, then the cross section of this plane will look like, imagine a cube, a cubic shaped cake. It can be easily cut. Now, it is cut along this plane. Into how many pieces? Exactly 2 pieces. Now the 2 pieces are what? Prism like triangular pieces you are going to get. Now if this piece, 2 pieces are separated and 1 piece is placed in such a manner that the face is, the rectangular faces in front of you. This portion is I have written. This plane is written in front of you. It is turned. It is cut like this diagonally. Along the face diagonal it is cut. Two pieces are going to be there. One piece is removed. The other piece is what is turned and kept in front of you. So that the plane which was inside or the plane along which it is cut is in front of you now. What is asked in the problem you know? How does the plane is going to look like? Look like in what? In terms of what? In terms of the particles. Where are you? How many A's will be there? How many C will be there? All that we will have to say. And four diagrams are given in the question. You can see which one is going to be true. Which pattern or which diagram is going to be true, which gives you the face which is in front of you here. Now what I will do, this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D. Now this is what AB is, whether it is edge length or edge or it is face diagonal. It is the face diagonal of this upper face. DC is also face diagonal of this what? This is lower face. So here this is AB and this is CD. So AB is actually, it appears like edge now, it is no longer edge, it is a longer one. Therefore it is not square, it is rectangular. AB is here, this is the body face diagonal and this is CD is also face diagonal. And in an FCC, whatever the particle that is present in the corner are going to touch along what? Along the face diagonal in an FCC. Which is formed, C atoms form the cubic close packing or forms the FCC. That means C atoms are along with the face diagonal are touching each other. Now in the original what? In the original cube. Here I will have to write likewise. Now this AB is here, this is AB. So here this is what are these? These are all C. This is the edge length. This is the face diagonal. Similar to this AB, along the face diagonal in FCC, the three spheres which form FCC are in contact. That's why I have written. This is also another face diagonal. All the three are in contact with each other. They are also C here and therefore the C will come here. So totally how many C will be there? There are six C. So diagram which contains 6C first should be the, you will have to look into the four diagrams which contains 6C. In option 1 there is no 6 spheres, C spheres. Option B and option C and option D contain 6 spheres. So of the 3 any one. Now what we will have to think, where are B? C is given, B is given, all tetrahedral voids. A atoms occupy all tetrahedral voids and B atoms occupy all octahedral voids. Octahedral voids are actually edge centers are octahedral void and body center is an octahedral void. In this picture, this is the edge center. In this plane, I will consider this edge center and this edge center. These edge centers are not required because what is asked? You are asked to pick out or select how does this plane is going to look like. So in this plane, this is the edge center, this is the edge center and this is the body center. So therefore, how many A's are there? A atoms occupy all the tetrahedral voids, B occupy octahedral voids. So here is B. This is the edge center. This is also edge center and this is the body center. These are all B. So it looks like this. And then tetrahedral voids, A are there. They are in that. What are the tetrahedral voids along the body diagonals? This diagonal are body diagonals actually. A is here. So this is, these are the four A's in this plane. So this plane, after cutting and in case it is placed in front of you, slightly rotating the piece that is formed, would look like this. Six C's, three B's and four A's. And in the diagram, in the option, option C and option D appear to be same, but actually option B, C is correct. In option D, they have given this A and is touching A. It cannot be these two smaller ions. This is a bigger ion, and therefore there must be a gap between AA and this AA. So any diagram where 6 C's are there, 3 B's are there, 4 A's are there in the direction which I have shown, with the gap between A and A, is the correct diagram. And the answer is third option. I don't know to what extent you can understand this. However, this is the higher level. Indeed, in case you are expecting a higher level of question of what, based on the voids and based on the voids and the shapes of the crystal, based on that, if higher level questions are to be asked, these are the types of questions for which you should be prepared.